Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how you can implement forgot password or reset password feature in your Django project. Like when the user click on the forgot password button, we will send some token or some link to the user email or phone number, and user need to pass that token or user need to click on that link to change his password. I will be using the Django REST password reset package for implementing the feature of forgot password. For sending email, I will be using the SendGrid. So I am on the official website of SendGrid. I have a separate video on SendGrid, like how you can send emails through SendGrid. I will just give you a brief overview about it. First of all, you need to create your free account on SendGrid. After creating, this is the dashboard of my SendGrid account. After creating your free account, you need to authenticate those senders, or you need to authenticate your domain. You need to click on verify a single sender, and you need to authenticate a sender that will sending the emails. I have already verified some senders. After that, you need to create a new API key. So these are the API keys that I have already used for some of my projects. So this is the API key that I will be using in this project. After performing all these steps, SendGrid is ready to send emails to your recipient emails. So I will be following the official website, the official documentation of this package. First of all, you need to install Django REST password reset in your project. As you can see, I have already installed this package in my project, so I will not install this. After installing the Django REST password reset, you need to copy the Django REST password reset and paste in your installed apps in the settings.py file. This is my settings.py file, and I need to paste the Django REST password reset in my installed apps. After doing this step, I need to run the migrate command. So this package contains some tables that it will automatically create when I run the migrate command. Let's open my database. So these are all the tables that I will be using for this project. And this is a table that the Django password reset package create. So after doing this, I need to register the URL in the root URL patterns. I need to copy this line and go to the urls.py in my main file, that is my root URLs, and I need to paste it in here. Like when I hit the API slash API, my the localhost slash API slash password reset, it will ask me to enter my email. When I enter my email, if the email is valid, it will send me the token to that email. After that, I need to hit the confirm password endpoint, and I need to paste my token and new password there. I will show you how I will do this. After doing this step, I need to implement the signal to sending the email. In my user model, I have registered the signal. So this is the signal that with the name of password reset token created. I need to import these packages. This is the function that will be doing all the things. Like it is taking the password reset token as an argument, creating an email body with the text that this is a token, you need to pass this token, and this is the SendGrid. This is the code for sending emails to SendGrid. I need to pass the from email that is present in my environment variables file, the to email, that the user pass that I am will be get and that I will be getting from the reset password object. The subject of the email and the content of the email. It can be plain text or it can be HTML content. After that, I need to call the SendGrid API client that I imported from SendGrid. And then I need to send the email with the message. If the response is 202, it means the message is successfully sent, and I will be printing that the password reset email successfully sent to my email. If there is some error, it will display that failed to send the email. Let's run the server for this project by writing python manage.py run server. As you can see, the server is running on port 8000 without any error. So this is the root of my project. I need to hit the /user/login for login the user. This is the user already present in my database. I need to copy this user and paste it here. So note that the password of user is 123456789. When I click on post, as you can see, it is giving me the access token and refresh token with the message that user is successfully login. So let's suppose I forgot the password of this user. I need to go to this endpoint, that is the localhost /API/password reset. When I hit this endpoint, it will show me that the request should be the post request. I need to pass my email. So this is the email already present in my database. Let's suppose I paste some wrong email here. It will show me that the email is not present in database. Let's pass the correct email and I need to click this post button. If the message is okay, it means the email is successfully sent to the recipient email. So this is the email that I just received. You can see 0 minutes ago. And this is the token that the password reset library sent to me. It will expire after 60 minutes. You can set this expiry date by setting the variable in the settings.py file. I need to copy this token and I need to go to /API/password reset/confirm. So it is asking me to paste my token and paste my new password, like I am setting a new password. For example, I paste the wrong token here. It will show me that the token is not found. So I need to pass the correct token. I am resetting my password. So the password should be not common and it should not be entirely numeric. So let's try some complex password. Let's paste the token and try a password. And hit post. If the status is okay, it means the password is successfully set. If I copy my user again and paste it in JSON format and click on the post, it will show me that the email or password is invalid. So I need to pass my new password here that I just set as programmer123. So you can see the user is successfully logged in and it will also provide me the access and the refresh token. So in this way, you can implement the forgot password or reset password feature in your Django project. Thanks for watching.